the wrong table, Dan. There we go. Here, just in time to see the lag. And Colby's won that pretty easily. So winner of this match will play Isabella Di Giorgio in the grand final. That's a much better break from Colby there. She's timed the ball a lot better. Yellows look the balls initially. Everything available, just a bit of navigation the white required. Probably want to eliminate this ball, the yellow that's near the black, as soon as possible, and also the one that's above the black as well. Potentially could pose an issue or two, but the transition now, straight away, she can pop this ball in the middle. Land a little high on this yellow and then stun off the one that's above the black, or to the right of the black as you see now, and she can stun onto the other one that's just near the black. So it looks like she's done exactly that, but I think she might not be high enough, hard to tell. No, it looks like she has got the angle. There's one other hurdle after eliminating these two balls, and that's just the transition between the middle ball, the ball over the middle pocket there, and these the remaining two balls, mainly because of that red's going to limit the amount of white ball movement that can occur on the yellow that's over the pocket. And I don't like that shot. And now this transition has become 1,000 times harder, because this problem ball that I spoke about near the black may be an even bigger issue. Unless you can run through now, play it in the center. Hasn't hit it hard enough. Well, she just walked up like she played exactly for where she's landed, so I just don't see an easy transition here. Don't think she can avoid the red. Here's a much better angle of the gap, and to me it looks like you can't avoid the cannon on the red, which means it's going to be more difficult to pull the white out to the right hand side of the table. So opting to play the yellow in the middle now. Needs a good white here, overhit. And just bear in mind this table was just, it was just brushed, sprayed with water, padded, and then ironed. So it should be flying. If I'm Colby here, I'm actually not even touching this yellow near the black anymore. I'm probably just moving the yellow that is near the red, even though it's covering the red. I'd probably move it and just get a good white. Put around a bit of pressure. Don't know if she's looking at playing this off the black or not. It's risky, but it might be the best shot. No, just playing a safety. That's a good shot. Didn't get the white exactly where she wanted, left the ball in the center. Really, I guess you'd really want the white either center on the nameplate, or probably even more preferably behind the other yellow over the pocket. Now obviously Rare's got options here. Good opening pot there. Problem is, I don't think you want to pot too many balls here because you're not going out unless you get an extraction. And you've also got a couple of tricky balls on the left-hand side of the table. And as you can see, she didn't pot that ball. She had a snooker or was good enough as. Does have an angle. It might possibly just off the bottom rail and into the dodgy red, but she's played the white in a similar spot for another partial snooker. Now, Kyle will be faced with the decision of what to do with this yellow. I think playing it towards the pocket is actually a mistake. The reason I say that is there's heaps of areas on the table that Rio will be able to put the white ball to put Colby in a snooker or not on the balls. You want as little amount of the table as possible for Rio to be able to land in where you'll be left a shot. So I'm more tempted to try and hit the right side of this yellow. Or even just play a full ball into the red that's just below it. Keep it in play. But chooses to not listen to anything I say, kills the black, and I really don't like that shot at all. It's so tempting to push a ball. It's right, you know, it's sort of in the middle of the table over towards a pocket because you think, oh, it's near the pocket, so it's on. It's going to be pottable. But the amount of options it's going to limit you to, and the amount of options it gives your opponent to manipulate the frame into a better position for themselves is huge. Whereas if this yellow had been stuck sort of more central to the table right now, this shot Rio is about to play now, probably not an option. I don't even know why she's potting these balls. She's not going anywhere. I mean, yes, this red's going to go over the pocket, but Colby's likely to just pot it. Might not be pottable now, but now even if you use the yellow to pop the red and leave a foul snooker, I've seen much easier outs for two from the white and the balk line. I'm not sure why she's jacking up here. She pulled the yellows out. I don't even understand that one bit. I would much prefer to a foul there and say have a foul snooker. She had to pull three balls out in one shot and then another one over the other side of the table in one shot to be able to finish that visit. And that also is another shot I wouldn't have played. But I'll tell you what, does this red pass the yellow, the black? And I tell you why I don't like that shot is because all it does is just allow Colby to bring this yellow out into the open. She tried to do that shot before and it stayed there. Now, if Rio doesn't play that plan and then promotes her two reds, she could hit a lot of it, but she could have still hit a little bit of the red. Just brought at least one of them into open play. She would have had she'd be in a much better position than she is now. Colby may flick off the left-hand side of this, so that way she doesn't just leave Rio right behind the red so she can go into the three balls. But risks going in off as well. She hits it too thick. Well, this could be a foul. Well, it's rolled in nicely. But I still don't see where this black's going, though. out. I don't see a lot of value in potting this yellow. I mean, you do have the, I guess you've got the option of potting it and then just bringing the black out to the center of the table and just putting pressure on Rare to say, oh, listen, you've got two dodgy balls. I'd rather do it with the yellow, just double it off the nameplate back to the center table and say, here, I'm putting my ball in a position where you better not leave me an angle to get the extraction. I don't see a way to get on this black other than a triple. Good pot from Colby, but I just don't think this goes anywhere. I could be wrong, double might be on, but to me, it looks like absolutely nothing's on here. Yeah, so you just tried to flick the black out and leave the reds dead, but it was a tough ask, that shot. And Rio should not lose his frame from here. Oh, she's actually giving Colby a half sniff here. I think she can get enough purchase to take a crack at the double in the top right. At worst, I guess a double in the centre, but I mean, obviously both low percentage shots, but when you're faced in a position like this, you don't have a choice but to take a low percentage shot on. And I'll tell you what, that's not a bad white. And I'll tell you something else that's good about this is Rio has to pot the ball over the hole now first. Then she's going to have to pot the ball over the middle. And then she's going to need to play a good shot, like a well-cued shot on her final red to transition to the black to either top corner or if she's got the angle to screw back for the middle. Probably going to have to run through off the side rail here. This is a preference thing too. Some people prefer to play the slight blind pocket shot. Others prefer to take the white ball more center table and play the inside type cut. Rio said, I'm not gonna play either, as I'm playing a snooker and I'm gonna leave you fat on this black. There's a bit of Jess going on out there, but I can assure you right now, neither of them are wanting to lose. And the Jedi Knight lightsaber has come out. Great black. Oh, I thought that was in. That did not look like missing, actually. No, it's not. Missed by, oh, actually she might have fluked it in the middle. Whoa. Didn't deserve to pot it, that's for sure. It was missed by 3 kilometres. Now this, believe it or not, is missable. I don't expect her to miss it, but it is missable. Most of the time people miss these, they hit it too thick. Now, if she overcompensates and hits it too thin, she could pot the red. But actually, all good, no danger. And a double strawberry there to cap off the first frame. See the other non-qualifying matches going. Last score I heard. Last I heard, Jane Partridge and Gov were 4-all. Rio's just gone launch about. I might get JoJo to get a score update actually for the non-qualifiers for me. So Katrina is 3-2 up on Emma. Someone's 6-4 up, we don't know who. Gov's 6-4 up on Jane. In fact, they've just finished, have they? I think Gov has won 7-4. Katrina 4-2 and we'll play Gov if she wins. No, Gov will play the winner of that match, the loser of that match. Winner. Is that a final? Am I in that? I should be. I deserve to be in the last man standing, the effort I've put in here today. Taking my focus off his frame for a quick second, and I'm not sure whether Kobe's still carrying two shots or not. I think she is. Although, actually, I don't know. She might not have potted ball for break, actually. So that's the first ball that's been potted, so yeah, she's only got one shot. Oh, hang on. No, Rio went off the table. So, no, she might still have two. The viewers at home are going to know more than me right now. And I'm commentating, that's pretty sad. A little delicate cannon here on these two balls. It's worked out nicely. Just the one shot. Thank you to Shell, who's all over the cue ball TV streams at most times. Shell Grundy. Yeah, loves the cue ball TV stream to the Shell Grundy and a lot of the Tasmanians for that matter. Yeah, not all of them, that's right. Tricky transition, this. It's difficult on the camera angle to tell what angle is. It's clearly not one that she can run through and get onto the ball that's to the left of it, otherwise she would have already done it. Oh, and that's no good either. I think she can stun. Just stun past the... No, the stun's not on, actually. That red will get cannoned. It's very difficult for me to be able to read this shot because I don't know exactly what angle she's got, but if she can stun past the red for the yellow on the top right... Yeah, that's just not the way to play that shot. There wasn't actually a dead weight, no matter what. With you going into the red, you're never going to land on this yellow. If you were going to play that and go into the red, you had to give it a bit. Let's just say she does give that a little bit. There'd be separation between the red and the yellow. The white would come through a little further, and she would have had at least a shot. Now, I don't believe Colby's going to try and pot this because I don't, unless it sneaks past it to the middle, but she, no, she's just bringing it out into play. Probably not super happy about where it's landed because Rio has stacks and stacks of options. another missed, easy missed pot. Now, if Colby can punish here by potting this yellow and getting on the black, it could be a real big stamp of authority in this match. Tough pot this. It's more the position on the black that's the tougher part about this. Not only do you need to make a good pot, you probably need to come off two rails skinny down the right side of the table and let on the black, or play for the middle. Actually, the more I look at this, the more the angle actually looks pretty natural to play at plain ball. I think as long as you can, as long as the angle the white takes doesn't hit the jaws at the top left-hand pocket, you should come side cushion, bottom cushion, and down the right side of the table. Here it goes. Oh, she's just caught the jaw, but she's landed on the other middle with a little bit of luck. She'll cop that. It's a good pot. Deserved a little bit of luck. And that was from a gifted turnover as well. And a good black there from Colby. They're not as easy as they look. And 2-0, and Rio doesn't want to go getting herself 4-0 down against Colby to make the 6-2 comeback. Not the greatest time break again. Well, Dan's wish of a really fast match may have just come to a halt, because this looks like it's going to take a bit of time to pan out, possibly. We've been really blessed to have Jason Foster walk into Bar 8 and be involved in this. And if you've been watching the Facebook wars between him and Steve Jamison, keep watching. If you haven't, if you don't know what I'm talking about, just go and look at Jason Foster or Jason Foster's wall or Steve Jamison's wall or pretty much any eight ball player in Australia's wall, because I think he tagged all of Australia in it. Well, this frame's worked itself out a little more now. There's not so much clusterage. Black ball's going to be an interesting transition a little later for yellows if they were the first to get there. Yeah. Not a bad white. Colby just gets a little flick off the red there and says thank you very much. And a big chance to take this frame from here. I think the bottom of these two will pass, and that will be the preferred red. Yep, taking the bottom of the two. And missed. Very sure Colby wanted to pot that because, well, if you look at the balls, they're all available. I think that the interesting part would have been to see how she transitioned to the black. Good double there from Rio, it's a super shot. Doesn't want to clip the yellow over the pocket here, and doesn't. Good shot again. So this black ball transition is key, and it's going to be this shot here. The key is getting a good angle on this yellow, because I don't think the black will go to the left corner inside the red, not at that angle. So she's going to need to get an angle. She doesn't want to be touching the rail for starters. She touches the rail, this is all over. She wants an angle where she can actually screw off. That has been played very, very well. Played cushion first with a touch of left-hand side. And now screw off a side rail and in behind the black. Could choose to just stun down in the gap, but I think it's actually easier to screw off a side rail and in behind it. You widen your angle. Okay, she decides that the black is going inside this red, so I may have misjudged it. But I'll tell you what, she just catches this red a little bit and the red will drop. They're tough inside the balls on these tables, but let's see what happens. There you go. It wasn't as easy as it looked, I don't reckon. But now the black goes easy because it's not near the rail. You're not shooting into, like, you know, you basically didn't have the jaw to work with when you're along the rail, and that's what makes the shot tougher. Now you've got the jaw to work with, so you can squeeze it inside the red using the jaw. Much easier shot. Colby sort of under the pump here. I don't mind the double back down onto the black and red. Might even be able to get a good white too, behind that red on the right side of the table. Even the black contact will be good here. Oh, well, she's got the white though, like I spoke about. And, you know, like I said, if I hadn't even mentioned that shot, some people might have said she was really lucky to get the white ball there, but it was, to me, it looked like a bit of a shot to nothing. Did overcut it by a fair way. But I'll tell you what, this to me, the only option here, well, there are two options. Play the swerve or use the jaws of the opposite pocket to play across. And that is such a hard shot, especially on these tables. I like the swerve here if she's not, oh, maybe she's just on it. Wow, she's that was never going in, by the way. Hitting it, yep, but never potting. Now, Colby has options, but I think the option she will choose is to attack these. She's got an opener with a plant. It shouldn't be too hard to hold the first red that she hits in the same vicinity, so it goes inside the black. And then she'll want to use that and try and transition up to the ball in the bulk area straight away. You don't want to leave that ball till last. Wow, okay. Colby felt that she had to move the red away from the pocket. They didn't like the idea of trying to hold it and play the red inside the black again. So I chose to just give it a little bit. Trust to a little bit of luck with the red. It hasn't worked out amazing. Okay, so now we've got this top ball. Or might play the red that's in the middle, like in the open first. And then play up for that top ball and then try and screw onto the side rail for the final ball down the cushion. Oh, I needed to get into that a little more. Wanted to really be higher up the table, probably another foot. So that way her angle was, she could screw down past the center pocket. Now she's gonna have to play long range shot on the ball on the cushion as well. Looks to be queuing well now. Now, we have seen a little bit of hugging going on of the balls down the rail, so she may drag this in and just let the hug do the work. She has chose to hit it soft, and I'll tell you what, she's hit it perfect. That's a really good out, that. Very good out. And that will give her a lot of confidence going into the rest of this match and the final, if she happens to take this match. Also, just remember, Colby is the current defending champion of this league as well. I would welcome Steve commentary to the Steve Jamison to the commentary, but he got tipped over last night, so he didn't make it. Good break there from Rao. Ball down. Two balls down, and initial glance, I don't mind the yellows. Just need her head to move out of the way so I can see this little clustered area. Yeah. So Rio says, yep, I agree. I want yellows as well. I don't think I'll be playing this one first, though. This is just going to cannon the red off the side rail. Might see Colby just drop in for a little snooky here. Don't know why Shannon's just, I don't see the problem with just a little snooker here. Just fall in behind it, no big deal. Nice shot there from Colby. It was important that she landed fairly straight on this red. Would love to have just gone down just a touch more so she could just float in between the gap in between the yellow and the red. And then she just had a, she would have had a really nice angle just to head back down to the bottom of the table. We'll have to sacrifice a little bit of precision here and just try and get as straight as she can without snookering herself behind the yellow. Nice little stun run through there, nicely played. And this angle looks pretty good. It's going sort of close-ish to the red on the left-hand side. But I don't think it'll cannon or anything. I think this will all be about a good pace. Just wants to land just off straight on it, as is the case in most instances. And that's probably a little bit weighty and may have to play the long ball now. But she pot only just reached the pocket then, so probably couldn't have played it much better than she has, and basically forced now to play the long ball and screw back. Don't have to screw back into the car park. As long as you leave an angle, both either putting the white ball hard up on the rail or close to, or giving yourself an angle the other way so you can get back up the table. I really like if she can get the white ball on the bottom cushion, or just like basically like half an inch off the bottom cushion, where she can screw back across the table in behind the black, so she'll have choice of corner or left middle. Oh. And the angle she had there wasn't awesome either. Might have been able to punch it off too. Make a mess of that red, and she's been very successful in doing so. Interesting to see what Colby does here, because that red is dead in the water. Has an option to face cut this double on the other red, back up the other end of the table and try and sort of bring it into play. The black's pretty dead now. It's better for Rio because she's got a yellow near it to transition to it nicely. Colby doesn't have that luxury anymore. And I just don't even see the point of trying to pot that. I don't understand what she would have accomplished by potting that at all. I've just read something on Facebook that does disturb me a little. And I like to address my critics. I'm just going to leave you with that for a moment. We'll finish this frame off and then I'll address that particular critic. Great shot there from Colby. And this is what I said earlier. She needed to bring that red into play and make something happen with her dead red earlier. Risky shot this from Rio, needs to be careful. Don't know if the yellow will pass the red, but if it doesn't, probably needs to just sit it inside and cover the pocket. Yeah, hasn't got it right. And this whole time, this to and fro has been going on with these yellows and reds, where there's been, you know, a couple of mistakes or an attempt to get back into the frame. The whole time, this black's just sitting there saying, I'm in a very, very bad position. Who's going to do what with me? As I said, Rio's got the better position for the black. Colby may be forced to have a dip here and play for a double. Not ideal. Tried to promote it to the center pocket, didn't quite get the weight right. Don't mind playing this down the rail and then playing the double. It's not really a lot of options on available, so you might as well have a dip and try and win the frame. I'm sure that's going through Colby's mind at the moment. Wow, this is hugged a mile.
Wow,
he's right. Now, the way Colby's obviously not happy that went in, she didn't want it to go in. She wanted Rio to try and cut her own throat the next shot. But I'll tell you what, she cans this double. Rio's probably going to be the one that's upset that it's rolled, so... How's the center pocket look? Yellow was in the way. Rio should have no problems taking this frame now. Now, there is obviously several ways you can go about this, but the real obvious way is to play the bottom right corner, the ball in the center, the ball in the top left, and then the black. You don't have to do anything with any shot. And it's just incredible how Rio chooses to go a different way, as I said, but that's very not surprising at all. But now the reason I suggest the way I said is now she's actually got to do something with the white. She's got to move it into an area so it just makes the last yellow less and more difficult. Yes, this shouldn't be missed. Yes, she won't miss it. But imagine if she had the ball in the middle and she was 3 foot closer to this yellow. There you go. And she's got very lucky with the snooker there. But that just emphasises my point of even when you've got three balls over the hole pretty much, choosing the correct way to go out still needs to be done. I'm very interested to see how you would have played that out, Rachel King. And we'll get to that now that we've almost concluded this frame. I got a bit of criticism from Rachel. I'm all up for criticism, don't get me wrong. But the reason that I'm selecting the shots that I would play is because they know what shots they're going to play out there. They're playing them. I'm trying to give them options that they might not see so they can go back and look at this feed and learn from it. That is actually the reason I've been called in to do the commentary for this. Do I want to be here and commentate? No, I want to be home and watch the UFC. But I'm here commentating, trying to help the game. So thank you for your opinion, but that is the reason I'm here. And nice shot there from Rio along the rail. And she will get on the board. And she'll be feeling a lot better about herself now, even though that was a horrible, horrible frame. I just have to wonder what Colby's feeling like after Rio's missed that ball by 4 foot and then gets a snooker. Probably not stressed, so she's 3-1 up and probably knows that didn't deserve to win the frame anyway. It was one of those ugly frames that you sort of see in the middle of matches now and then. I don't expect every frame to be like that for the remainder of this match. We've seen some high quality pool today and I'm sure that'll continue on. I think the standout for me has definitely been Bella so far. Her aggressive style, her action, her commitment to the shot. And the only thing that's kind of let her down a little bit is just a choice of shot here and there. But I'd like to see Bella start playing in as many tournaments as she can, trying to mix it with the men. And basically elevate her game from there. Because she's well and truly already mixing it with the women. She's played her first national title. She's made a semi-final, quarter-final. I think it was a semi. And shot well in the stats, made the Australian team. Now this is all first-year player to 15 years of age. The next logical step is to start playing a high level of competition. And without sounding sexist or chauvinistic, that is to play against the top elite men. They play the game differently. They're more aggressive. They make less mistakes. And when you start getting punished for the mistakes that you're making, you will look for ways to learn and improve and stop making those mistakes so you can start mixing it with those guys. I can't say it enough, she is a prodigy for us at the moment in Australia as far as women's eight ball is concerned. She is a future world champion. And as long as she decides to stick to playing the game, gets the right coaching, and does the right things, I don't think there's much that can stop her. But anyway, back to this match. It's a good shot with the rest. No one likes using it. And a good opportunity here to take the frame. The tricky part here being these two reds on the right-hand side. However, if Rhea can just get the right angle, she'll be able to pot one and develop the other. And you don't have to belt it out. You can just... let it just play the shot first. And this is the opportunity to get on that shot I'm talking about right now, possibly. But you need to be on the basically in between the red and the black. And you're going to pot the red that's on the right of the two and nudge the other one just past the yellow to the rail so it slides past. The only issue now is
after she plays that shot, she's not really going to have anything to transition from. So this has become a tricky out. I think the yellow comes into play here on the bottom cushion, should she choose to play it now. I don't think this cannon will happen now. I'm not against her putting the ball over the pocket here. I just don't see the out being simple now. And see, this is what I'm talking about. Even if she pots this ball on the right-hand side, where is this one on the left going now? It's a bit dead in the water. A double might be a good option. In a position now, we almost forced to try and commit to something big because a safety is pretty difficult. Look, you could just bring this red out and stun the white ball to the bottom cushion and try and land hard up on the yellow that's on the bottom cushion. That's one sort of option to try and keep your opponent limited in shot. May aggressively just take this onto the middle. That's what she tries to do. Took it aggressively to the middle. How's the weight? Well, I reckon that's curved a mile on her. But the white ball, though, wasn't there for position. Had that have gone in, a bit more pace, would have floated up the table and had a shot. And Colby now faced with a fairly open table. I'd be very interested, too, to go back and count the number of frames that we've seen where the player has broken down when they're trying to pot out and they've broken down with only one or two balls left on the table. That is the type of pull that will lose you lots and lots of matches long term, is if you keep breaking down right towards the end of your outs, it will not benefit you long term, I can promise you. That right there, if you're going to improve something in your game, is not breaking down at the end of an out. Even if you've got to just wait a shot or two and develop the frame a little better. Obviously, every frame's different. It's really difficult to, you know, to say, oh, you need to do this frame, and this, that frame. It's impossible to be able to predict until you see the balls, but there's no point in potting a bunch of balls and then breaking down, just clearing traffic for your opponent to do whatever they like. Key shot here coming up for Colby. Good shot. Now the only problem ball now, if you're going to pick one of these five, is the one that's close to the black. That shot that Rio played on the double cut the yellow off to the centre. So it needs to just find a way to get onto that. Oh, she's made it even trickier now. May choose to screw off this yellow into the yellow on the black, and then she'll have the ball along the rail. No, just deciding to control the white all the way through. And there's nothing wrong with the way she's going about this. And finally, 5 hours later, when he said he was going to turn up, Steve Jamison has finally waltzed on in. Welcome, Steve.
Good afternoon, Jamie. Thanks for getting me in a hell of a state last night.
It was my pleasure. And that is a good little nudge for Colby there. She's got an angle to come around the angles. May need a little bit of left-hand side.
So is this the final?
This is the semi.
Semis, okay.
Bella, you missed a very good match in Bella and Rio. Sorry, Bella and Colby to get into the final. Bella won 7-6, yes. It's been a lot of 7-6s today. Rio's had 2 7-6s.
So this is the double chance for Colby, is it?
No, the double chance has been done.
So what are they playing for?
This is to get into the final against Bella. That's a great shot from Colby there.
So who did Bella beat in the semi, sorry?
Colby, 7-6. And now Colby's playing Rio.
Is it a round robin or something?
No, Colby had a double chance.
Oh, yeah.
You couldn't have picked that up and put it any better with your hand, and probably could have played that slightly better, but I don't expect any issues here.
seen similar blacks missed by Western Australian team in the Nationals this year.
Oh,
after a fist pump.
Rough.
Sorry to.
Was that Nathan McMahon?
That it was Nathan. Yep.
I did
I'm
see
sure
that.
He's heard enough about that since it happened.
I had a bit of a chuckle on that one myself when I saw it, but look, he's not actually the first person to do that. Nick Young did it one year for us, and actually he did that in the Northern Territory. Did the big fist pump against SA and then chopped up. I've even seen back home in the local league a fist pump happen where one of the guys has played a huge shot, the black's right over the pocket. He's done the big fist pump because the black's unmissable, and he's actually miscued and jumped the white right over the black into the pocket.
Oh, goodness.
I've never seen anything like it since.
So 4-1 to Colby.
Yeah, now, Rio's had a bit of a weird day today. She was 6-2 down against Caroline and come back and won 7-6.
Mm.
She was 4-1 up on Lyndall Element. That ended up getting 6-6 and she won 7-6 in a really scrappy final frame.
Yeah.
The whole match was a pretty scrappy affair. And this one has just been a bit of a case of where Colby's actually doing the punishment now for the errors. She's making Rio pay for basic mistakes. Well, in most cases anyway.
So it's a bit of a long day for the girls. For Colby to come back and win the grand final would be pretty.
I think the person that if they made the final on it would be huge would be Rio, because she has basically not stopped playing all day.
Yeah.
She has not got off the table except to take a 5-minute break before her next match. She's the only player in the room that hasn't had a break. So for her, and she's had to go through Caroline, then Lyndall, now Colby, and then if she won that, she'd have to go through Isabella as well to win it. And that would be an enormous day of pull.
Yeah.
I think so, yeah. 4-4 on the table between Katrina Defina and Emma Barbudo. As you can see on your screen there in the background, there's a little score sheet.
How many viewers have we got, Dan? Forty viewers from all around the world.
Yes, we had a viewer on from Belgium earlier.
Seriously?
Huh? Yep.
So we're back in.
Dan thought, you don't really want to see that break. And have a look at these yellows.
It's of the dry variety.
Rio will be filthy, because have a look at this. There's only one problem here, and it's these two on the left-hand side that just need to be made a little bit neatly into a plant, or just get a little cannon on one and open up the other.
I'd be tempted to take the one on the bottom right and play the cannon, because then you've got the backup ball over the pocket.
Colby said, no. I'm going to play the thin plant, maybe.
Quite like this shot. Just drop the one on the right-hand side in. And then
you like the cannon?
Yeah.
You just need to be careful with the cannon. You don't cannon it. She's going to play.
Not the plant, not the cannon.
I like the thin plant better. It's easier to control. She hit it way too thick.
Yeah, it was quite thin. Had to be hit quite thin, but yeah. See that? That's where you should. I've been told by a lot of my mentors that. You should try and get your dead ball out as early as possible.
Absolutely.
And that, there was an angle to get it out there.
I didn't actually think so much that it was dead.
No, but the trickiest ball first is what I've been sort of told. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, absolutely. And that shot Rio's just played there has not really done anything for her, because she's left Colby on the ball that she covered.
Yeah, this is...
Colby can basically say, all right, well, I've just made an error. I'll continue on my way from where I was a freebie shot. And this is one of those frames where, like, Rhea is just in a world of hurt straight off the bat. She's got a ball covered up the top. She's got balls covered down here. All of Colby's balls are over the pocket. She's just wrapped to get to the table. And she's going to get to the table. Now, I think she needs to smother this yellow.
Yeah.
I think she needs to smother this yellow and keep herself in the frame for a couple more visits at least. I mean, what's amazing about this frame now is if she was on a ball right now, you'd be half tempted to maybe have a dip because you can get behind these balls. They're not completely covered.
No.
But I like the smother. She's going across table. This is suicide.
That's the shot of someone who's pretty much had enough.
It's the shot of someone that thinks their opponent's not going to pot out.
Yeah, that's true, actually, yeah.
I would be quite insulted if I was Colby with that shot. Basically just saying, I don't rate you from here.
I'm sure that's not the case, I think.
No, it's not. I don't know why she's not potting. Actually, she's not potting the ball over the pocket because she wants to use that for the black.
Yeah, that's smart to keep it there, I think. Just, can she get one of these bottom yellows?
I think she's got the three ball plant. Well, I'd be hitting it a little bit harder than that.
Uh-oh.
I'd have actually played that thin on the right side. Let the white ball come off the bottom cushion.
Yeah, so.
Dan's giving us a good angle. There's a truck through that red.
Yeah, so it shouldn't be a problem. Still gotta be just careful here not to jam the yellow. That's a good shot.
Now, Steve, she might even play the double here. Maybe. I was just mentioning to the viewers earlier on today, Steve, while you were probably still asleep, how you gave me a 45-minute rundown of how bad my stance and queuing action is last night.
Yeah, I think I was fairly inebriated at the time, so apologies.
I took a lot from it.
But yeah, I think ultimately what I've learned as well over the years is that there's some very unique actions out there from very good players, so it's... It's not necessarily one way of doing it, you know.
I have to say, I find it hard to agree with that choice of shot because things can really go wrong now.
Yeah.
She's got all these reds to clear with the white.
Yeah.
Or she's got to play like a soft screw and hold the white and then hope that the ball that she plants, the one that she's hitting, stays over the pocket.
No, she won't do that. She'll be trying to get on that middle yellow or get the white on the right-hand side of the table. Somewhere near the middle pocket if she can.
But she's got so much traffic to clear now. What's she doing here playing this in the middle?
Crikey, that's a surprise. Oh, she's playing a snooker. Okay, that's a good shot.
Yeah, that's a very good shot.
I didn't even spot that one. So well done, Colby.
Yeah, that's basically I don't like the risk associated with this and attached to this shot. Snooker's the easy option here.
Yeah.
And it's a good snooker. I mean, it's easy to get out of, but it's not easy to leave your opponent no shot afterwards.
Just one question. Are those two reds in the middle there a plant into the middle pocket?
Yeah, I had a look at it. I don't think they do.
It doesn't look like there's an angle either to get up and down for the ball near the pocket. So I think this is going to be a bit of a...
It's just going to be a smash, yep. She says here, so, I'm going to leave you fat on this ball.
There you go, that's not shot A, so Colby will just run this in and out of bulk and play the yellow on your top left of your screen as the second shot. Shouldn't be any problem here, just has to obviously avoid going in, putting the white in the middle.
Yeah, good shot.
Looks like she's playing pretty well. Has she been playing well all day?
A bit on and off. I think overall she's not playing too bad. And obviously, as you know, I'd be probably more critical of Colby than anyone else in the room. So for me to say that I think she's playing pretty well is a good assessment to say that she probably is, because if she's missing more than what I believe she should, then I'll say straight out she's playing bad. But overall, she's mopping up tricky outs when she needs to. Her action was really dodgy early on. She had that wrist movement going on, but that seems to have cleared up now. She's a bit more focused. The one thing that I will comment on that I'm happy to see is her speed around the table is much better from shot to shot. So, yeah. Those three balls there, four balls are all simple, mm. but when she's struggling or just not in the right frame of mind, that would have taken her 2.5 minutes to pot out there.
Yeah.
That's just taken her 40 seconds to pot those. And yeah. I believe that if she continues to use that speed of play around the table, especially when the balls are on, mm-hmm. I think that's when she can basically dominate her opponents.
Yeah.
I mean, not only do you finish racks quickly, you rack scoreboard pressure up faster. It just puts your opponent under pressure, and this is something that Rusty Wheeler's a genius at. You just bang, 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 before you know it, 3-0 down, 4-0 down, 5-1, 6-2.
Yeah,
you know,
scoreboard pressure.
He's just running racks off left, right and centre, and a lot of players find it difficult to deal with that.
Yeah, it's such a psychological game, this game. I think that's why I enjoy playing this game the most out of all the Q sports. Because it's not necessarily that hard a game to pop balls, because it's a smallish table, but the psychology and the mind games that you know people play on you and you play on yourself, it makes it really interesting.
Yeah, it's definitely your own mind that can cause the most problems rather than an opponent's.
So it didn't really get much stun on that ball there. It was more of a sort of jump or a bounce on
the
pack.
Yeah, it's all been Colby's timing on her break. She actually broke a lot worse than that earlier on today. And I had a quick word to her, and we just quickly spoke about the break. And I suggested to her that she just try and stay still and not try and move her body into the break.
Mm-hmm.
And just get the timing from that. And then if she starts feeling it, then she can start launching herself into it. Now, you know, Temujin made a comment earlier, when you watch Isabella break, her head doesn't even move. And she's been getting the best splits today.
Her head doesn't even move.
Head does not even move. Everything is still. But she just gets through the ball nicely. She times it well and she's getting great splits.
Yeah. I don't see a lot of the women players screwing back off the pack. I see a lot of them playing with topspin. Do you notice that?
I don't think it's necessarily a deliberate thing. I think that when they move and they jump up, it's just the cue comes up a little bit as well,
mm-hmm.
off center of the wide or slightly below, and so they just hit it with top by mistake.
Colby's looking at this three ball plant in the left. I quite like it, although the red she's hitting, if she plays it, might go to the bottom of the table, which will make the finish quite tricky. And I'm not a fan of this red on the right-hand side of you, near the middle pocket, if it doesn't go.
I think it does go to the left middle, but you've got to get behind it.
Hmm. Oh, she's on yellows. Or she's potting
a
yellow.
She's choosing yellows, yeah.
Oh, so deliberate foul.
I think she's decided that the security...
Oh, sorry, she's chosen the yellow.
Yeah,
open
I think
table.
The security's okay. In the yellow. She's just going to block this pocket now.
Yeah, so 5-1 up. 5-1 up, she's saying, you do all the work, Rio, I don't have to chase anything.
Sorry, say again?
Colby's saying, I'll just keep it tight, keep the pressure on, 5-1 up.
Yeah.
And you've got to do all the work?
Yeah,
she want to beat me?
She's almost going autopilot in regards to playing the correct shot to tighten the screws.
Mm. It is a nice feeling, isn't it, when you've got a really good lead and you... And you just play a very sort of tight pool, and you know your opponent wants to get into a rhythm and come back at you.
This is a go at me having ear stage.
No, but I must admit, I do remember feeling like that against you on more than one occasion. Now, I quite like bottom left red off the yellow here. Oh no, it's just Colby at the table. So.
Yeah, Rhea just played a shot.
So she's on yellows.
How do you like the...
But I think that red goes off the yellow, doesn't it?
Which one?
The one near the left corner pocket, I think the red slides off the yellow in the middle of those three in the left corner as a plant. If it's played slowly, or actually no, medium pace.
What do you reckon? Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah.
I think at least there's a chance of the red taking the pocket through that shot.
I reckon you'll see Colby just play another safety. Oh, is this ball on in the middle?
Don't think so, no. She's playing.
Oh, okay. She's tried to open up her yellow shot there. She's tried to open up her yellow and get a good white. That's a smart shot.
Yeah, what she's done again is just not really left much of a chance for Rio. She's got one up into the ball pocket, the red that's on the black spot. And I think she's trying to see if she can just put this red a bit closer to the pocket so she can...
A bit jabby.
Something. It's,
she made a bit of a mess of those, hasn't she?
It's not ideal.
I think because these are so close together, she can probably play across these yellows and still pot the other yellow that's closer to the pocket. Do you know what I mean? She can play across it and it'll still plant in.
Yeah.
No, she chose to just keep the screws tightened.
Yeah.
Not happy with the shot.
No, I think... I don't know if the yellows go now, do they?
No, I think they still will.
Still go?
I think Rio just asked the question whether it was a frozen ball or not, but Colby said she checked in and it wasn't.
Colby didn't seem very happy with that shot, but...
I think she wanted the white ball behind the yellow.
Oh, yeah. But I'm telling you now, this... You wouldn't fancy this, would you, if you're on reds?
No, I don't like this shot if I'm on reds.
There's very little you can do here. I mean...
I'm probably going to flick off the bottom side of this red to try and just use the jaw and tuck the white in behind the yellows. And
yeah, that's something. I quite like screwing into the left red and trying to push it closer to the black just to smother the black a bit more.
Look at this shot. Wow, that's a sensational nice shot.
Very nice double.
And, unfortunate with the white because not an easy follow-up shot.
And if both the reds that are near the pockets to pass the yellows, the left corner and the one in the right centre, then this out is on.
Yeah, it's this shot right now that's the key.
I think that black on top of the red on top of the black, I think it might go in the left corner.
You reckon it's on now?
I think it is, yeah.
So by this thin cut.
But it's also very promotable with the red on the black spot. So that's a...
Well, it's not bad.
That,
I think Colby now plays the ball over the middle and then plays a double on that ball that just got covered. Just try and stay a shot ahead. Although all these balls are on now, you've got to be careful.
Yeah, I actually don't think the out is on, so I don't see any value in potting anything. I think she just needs to try and take this pocket now. But if they're a plant... And it's going to be difficult to take a pocket.
I think you're going to play the three ball plant maybe and try and get the one that she's hitting, just try and get it to nudge in the way of the red a little bit.
Yeah. That's pretty good. Or does the red pass?
Don't think it will pass.
So, we're just seeing if she can squeeze this red through the gap. And probably doesn't want to pot it, but just take control of the pocket if she can.
Yeah, it's difficult to see what purchase she can get on this, but...
So she's gone for the B prize, which is half a cover. But I think Colby can, in potting this yellow over the left corner, I think she can...
I don't touch these now, Steve. I just get this ball at the top left-hand corner out into play. Like, that puts her a shot back ahead in this frame.
Yeah.
There's no need to touch these.
I think if she gets this full on at pace, it'll clear the red.
Wow. Oh, right. Wow. No, I promise you now, Colby's filthy with that shot.
So do you think Rio's going to go for this now?
I think as good as opportunity is there, otherwise the door could get reclosed.
Yeah, you'd be tempted, wouldn't you, just to have a dip here.
Well, she just opened the door for her. Rio gives her one more shot. Colby will just shut that door straight away.
Yeah, it's a sliding door.
It's one of those ones that goes in a circle. You got to walk into it before it closes on you and come out the other side. You don't even know what I'm talking about, do you?
I've got a picture of a reception type.
I think there was one on the Matrix.
I can see why Temujin got sick and tired of commentating with you.
That's a bit rough.
Okay.
Quite amazing. Is this the frame where all the balls were over the hole? Is this the same frame? Well, all the yellows were just on.
Yeah,
and it's amazing how like messy this frame's turned.
Some credit to Rio though for sort of scrapping back into the frame.
Yeah, she's definitely back in this frame now for sure.
Overhit that one, wanted to leave herself the double.
I'll tell you what, this holds up. Oh, she would have loved to have been really straight on that plant.
Surely she played to go up for the double there. Because you wouldn't leave that ball to last up there, would you?
I don't think she wants to commit to the out yet. If she had landed really straight on that red, it's near the black, she could have played to plant, but screwed off it and let the momentum of the first red that she hit follow through and cover the pocket. Then she can pop the ball over the middle and then bring the other, the double into play.
I think she's just going to take the pocket here, isn't she? Oh, that's pretty good.
Yeah, it's a pretty good shot.
I think that's jammed, touching both balls.
If it's touching both, she still needs to fire away from her yellow, and she will be within her rights to hit the yellow. So, what was all that? Colby just hit her Ray of Sunshine impersonation. So we're not sure what the deal is. Must be touching, she's shooting away from it. Yeah, and that's total, even if it was touching the yellow as well, which I think it might have been touching both, that's a legal shot.
So not a foul shot there?
No, as long as she's touching the red there, she's deemed as hitting it, so she's allowed to shoot into the yellow even if it's touching. If you're in the position where you've got two of your balls and you're touching both of them, then you have the right to nominate which one is the ball that you shoot away from, and you can actually hit the other one.
Yeah. I try not to talk about touching balls when the women are playing.
Yeah, fair enough. And
trying to keep it obviously a family show. So Colby might be trying the plant up and down the table, not?
Oh, so it doesn't want the black heart up.
Still in control here. Red's with a big problem down on the left-hand side.
And isn't it amazing, I suggested about, I don't know, eight, ten shots ago now, that she should pull that ball out of play when she played some weird shot, and then she promoted Rio's red, and she almost got herself out of this frame.
Yeah.
And then Rio chose to not commit when probably, you know, that door was open, and now the door's been shut well and truly in her face.
Yeah.
And these are the little things that, you know, I think are beneficial to them having a live stream, so they'll be able to go back and watch a frame like this and go, God, what should I have done there? I felt like I was just, you know, not in the right position, or I played the wrong shot, or I did play the right shot, and then, you know, you hear someone else talk about the shot, and it's, oh, geez, I didn't even see that shot. And this is what I was sort of getting at earlier when I guess you could say defended myself at why we're doing this. I don't profess to be right every time. In fact, I think I'm more wrong than right as far as predicting the player's shots. I'm good. Oh, just a little bit stiff there. Just get the jam.
It's worked out nicely though, because the yellow's now covering the black in the right hole. So it makes Rio's job even harder to get out, even if she does promote that left red.
Rio's primary thing right now is to try and not give Colby a pot out this next shot. What she wants to try and do is work another red down the table in front of these two yellows.
Mm-hmm.
But she can't really do that this shot. So she has to contain Colby in not being able to pot out this next shot. Now, that's a lot easier said than done, because this is really difficult. Is Rio looking at trying to bring the black up into world?
Yeah, she is.
That was a pretty big ask.
Yeah, I think she needed to go cushion first there, didn't she, to knock it up to bulk. Good idea, though, but not quite worked out, so two shots on yellow for Colby. You'd think this should be curtains.
Tell you what, not the worst result of all time with the white.
No, it's not too bad. Cause she's forced almost now into playing this yellow over the pocket, but no guarantees of where the white's going to go here if she has to play it with any pace.
Oh, she's played that really well.
Yeah, nice shot.
Did go down and check the squeeze as well, and very, very sure that was well planned out and executed as planned.
So, five roll-ins here.
Wow.
Surprised with that choice.
Not sure why she didn't just drop that in.
Wouldn't you have just dropped that in and then the bottom yellow?
Yeah, I think she was really focused on getting an angle on it so she could come back out of the table. If she just drops it in, she might not have had any angle. She's straight on that yellow.
Yeah.
This is still fine, though. You pop this ball in the middle and stun off the side rail a little bit, just get yourself straight.
She's got to put a bit of work on this now, though, and just needs to be careful not to lose the white or hit it too hard and the yellow jump out. It's played pretty well.
It's not bad.
Yep, so needs to just drop this in dead weight.
Yeah, it's interesting this. I'd actually drag this in with some right hand side.
Yeah.
Left hand side.
Oh, left?
Yeah, just to kill the white.
I would be doing right hand side.
No, left hand side to kill the white. To check it off the rail and just kill the white. Yep.
That's nicely done.
Actually, with the rest, I wouldn't have done it, though. Only if I had a hand on the table.
Yeah.
I'm happy to just pot it with the rest.
So she's still got the two. Doesn't want to miss this one because the black is not an absolute give me.
If she does miss it, though, it stays over the hole. You just got to back yourself to get behind the black and knock it in.
Yeah.
But I expect her to get this the way she's queuing now. Oh, and I was wrong.
Doesn't want that white to travel much farther. I think she's okay. I think it still goes.
How's her angle, though? Has she got any at all?
I think she's got to pinch the pocket a little bit here and absolutely smash it.
Smash it?
Or that's if it's dead straight, she's got to really smash it, but if she's got a little bit of angle, then she's fine.
She can just come off the back rail and back centre table. Yeah, she had plenty of angle.
In fact, that white has just shot up the table, and she's got a nice kiss there.
It's a good result in the end.
Yeah. She hasn't saved all her kisses for you today, Jamie.
No, I could be kissless.
So, and that kiss has also put that red into a little bit of a dodgy position. I think it does still go in the middle, but this black for a 6-1 lead.
Wow, she just smashes it. I'm surprised she didn't just play that dead white, actually.
Yep. So the old tap of the table there after a bad shot.
First sign of emotion from Colby as far as physically being able to see it's concerned. And at 5-1 up.
See, I'm a big believer in not showing any emotion when you're to your opponent, because I think your opponent can actually feed off that negative energy.
I'm a bigger believer in it as well, but I just have more trouble in it with it than you. I don't know, I'll wear my heart on my sleeve when I play this game, whether it be in a teams event or singles. I just...
Yeah, I spent a bit of time with a good youngster in Melbourne, a guy called Devlin Prager.
Yes.
Really fast improving young lad, and he used to have a really have a lot of body language and sort of negative body language, and kind of got cross with himself when he missed balls, and you often see him leaving his cue on the table after he walks away, pointing down sort of thing.
Yep.
And he's really improved, and I think worked hard on that. That's a good shot. And I think he's now starting to win a lot of junior titles and stuff.
Well, he also made the last 20 this year in the Open as well.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, and he I think he went into that really believing he could get through to the state team as well, which...
I'm not actually sure how he went as far as positional standing is concerned, but that's a real... Yeah,
would have been good experience.
Yeah, the first year you're playing, that's a real eye-opener. It's a mental battle, especially when you have these runs of wins and losses. It's really... That format's really difficult if you've never made a state team, and...
Yeah.
It will continue to be difficult until you make one, and then when you finally make one, the format's not so bad no more. It just feels, you know, like a good format that you want to be involved in.
Maybe if you know you can do it, you can make it. It makes it a bit easier than the something self-belief you've not done before.
She only got one here. One shot. Why does she not try and go around the angles there and get behind this red?
I'm not sure what she was doing there. She just. But maybe she was worried about the end off.
What's interesting about this, though, she does have the double to the corner that she'll be playing the black into, and the white will be left for. So if she doesn't get it, but the coverage is good, it might be okay.
I find with these, if I commit to the double, I get more of them. If I play it pocket way and try and do the shot, the kind of two-in-one shot, I usually miss the double. Yep.
This doesn't even look on this
and,
double.
And, by the way, I missed the double as well.
Wow, that's
great.
A great shot. She excellent hit it really shot well.
And by the way, this is taking place after Colby showed emotion, after missing a shot earlier, and I truly believe that the opponent feeds off that and grows in confidence, and it could be a big turning point though.
Potential turning point. We like the turning points here.
TP.
We're not as big as turning point callers as Mick Scarry, who likes to call turning point about 24 times a frame. But we do like to throw one in there now and then.
I saw Michael Scarry on Facebook Live last night, or recently playing Danny Julich for money, where Michael was playing with the rest every shot.
And he got rolled, I heard.
And I think he did get rolled, yeah. So well done, Danny Julich, for that world champion scalp. So 5-2 feels a lot better than 6-1.
It does.
Are you wearing incontinence pants today, Jamie, or have you been able to go to the toilet?
What do you mean?
Are you wearing like pants you can wee in, or have you had toilet visits?
No,
today?
I've had a toilet visit or two.
That's good.
I'm not a Chinese blackjack player.
Thank goodness you don't have a weak bladder. So, dry break. Open table here.
Steve, we may have to call you into the locals there. They're getting a little bit upset over there.
Yeah?
Talking about money games and things, I think.
Yeah.
It might be.
Yeah, they do. They're very passionate, the Bar 8 crowd on a Sunday afternoon.
Incredible. I've never seen anything like it if they're not even playing for anything. Well, this is dodgy bridging here from Colby, but she's got pretty skinny,
so
lanky
she's trying
fingers.
The double here, or?
Oh, she's miscued.
Oh. Is that a foul, or?
Pretty sure it was.
Or was it touching ball? Not quite sure if this is one or two.
I'm pretty sure it's two.
So yellows look favourable.
Well, I think Colby's on reds.
Is she?
Well, there's only six left, so... Oh, no, I'm wrong. Seven. She popped one off the break. Is it seven? I can't count. Yeah, wow, I'm so stupid.
It's a long day, mate.
Oh, that's a good super shot there from Rio. Very good opener. Really nicely judged. Ball in the middle.
Yeah, I still preferred yellows here, by the way.
Yeah, I did too.
Because that yellow near the middle pocket up there is very easy double. So
I think it goes in the middle anyway.
And it might, yeah, creep in as well. So this is a big shot in this comeback trail.
Oh, wow, and that's not a good shot.
Could not have been worse. She will not be happy with that. Oh, she's got two,
yeah,
of course.
I knew she had two, but I thought she should have played the ball in the middle.
I'll take it back, Rio. Sorry about that. Two shots indeed. And this looks actually pretty tasty now. I think the red that's between the three on the left-hand side goes off the rail, off the yellow near the pocket, which will open it up for the dodgy one.
Yeah, I agree. I think
so. Maybe just drop this in and cannon into the yellow dead weight.
I think she's going to hit it thin though.
I'll just be rolling this in dead weight.
I think she's going to hit that yellow thin or miss it. There,
okay.
Yeah.
She wasn't expecting that, but it's not too bad.
Yeah, she's got the same shot you were just talking about.
I don't like that shot at that pace because if you do clip the yellow, you're going right over to that top left pocket where there's danger. So this is the key shot to this pot out. Is to pot the red and clear the pocket, and neither.
However, did get a good white. By mistake, but still got one.
Yeah, it could have been a lot worse. I think the Jackie is on here, though.
This is a tough shot.
It's a very difficult plant.
Actually, I just don't think this shot is the right shot. Having said that, though, I'm trying to pick one that is better.
There's no alternative, really.
No,
is
there's not a lot on. I'd rather actually flick off the...
If this goes in, they're all on. Oh, dear.
I just thought that shot was just, like, 2%. I just thought it was super low percentage.
So some colourful language from the crowd. We've been joined by a recent Bairnsdale Cup runner-up, Joanne Brown.
I'll tell you what, I didn't even know the Bairnsdale Cup existed until someone said Bairnsdale Cup.
Yeah, Bairnsdale prestigious Cup. Event.
I said, I mean, Bairnsdale Cup just sounds like a... It just sounds like, you know, when they go to Tamworth for the country festival.
I did chuckle when we were playing. I was in the same team with Joanne. We were playing against JR's team, and I played JR, and I was reds, and I went yellow, and gave him two shots. Fortunately for me, he didn't pot out.
Are you telling me that JR had another team that won in one of these events?
No, we beat them in the semis. So
he's the biggest team rorter of all time. And Colby's actually in trouble this frame now. Yeah? Or is she on reds? Is Colby on reds or yellows?
She's on yellows.
Yeah, she's in trouble.
Yes, this is a pretty tricky situation here. I would say I'm not pulling out here. I'm trying to put another yellow down the left side.
Yeah, you can't. If you don't think you can go out or get the extractions, yeah, you kind of need to start smothering balls.
I think she seems to be going for this, Jamie.
Oh, picks the gap nicely. And that was sarcasm. She didn't want that.
Well, it's funny though, as she's lining that cut up, I just saw a shot that she could have played, and that was play the double, stun the white, and then she would have had an angle. It's a tough shot, but you cut the top two of these yellows across the bottom right and get a cannon full ball on the other yellow, bring it into play. You would need to have checked exactly what angle you needed for that full ball cannon off of the double, but at least it would have been a chance. So you can't really smother this with this yellow, because you can't smother both balls.
If you take soldiers off the battlefield here, it's suicide.
I don't mind her potting this and then bringing this other yellow down. At least it's something.
Yep. But I would have liked the safety to have happened at the start of this break.
But I didn't really see one, that was the problem.
Yeah, she could have doubled the yellow up and down the table.
Oh, yeah.
And added more traffic down there. So, it looks like it's pretty good.
I'll tell you what, you probably couldn't apply that any better than that.
I mean, it's sort of... I mean, Rio's obviously a million times favourite now to win the frame from here. But it's not going to be as easy as it was to get the clearance.
Yeah, it's getting to a point where she's got the opportunity to commit now, but it's got some risk attached to it.
Mm.
And there's nothing worse than committing to an out when you've got full control of the frame, and then something goes wrong and you lose the frame from it.
Yep.
They are heartbreakers, those type of frames.
I'd be half tempted, you know, to take the red in bulk and chop it in with left-hand side and try and get the cannon.
I'd be happy to just promote it and leave the white ball up there.
Oh, she might be playing the double here, no?
Double is crazy. Unless she's doubling at the bottom right. Doubling it back to this pocket is just a completely pointless exercise.
Yeah.
I like to double back this end, or just double at centre table.
Would you just let Colby work it out, how she's going to get that yellow out and not bother trying to go for it? That's a careless ball.
Oh, it's a bad shot.
Very careless shot.
Now, these balls will come out 2-1.
Tables are running extremely well up here. They're getting ironed once a week now, which helps a lot.
Well, they just got ironed and brushed and et cetera before this match, but we did see a couple of shots where it hugged the rail real heavily. Colby needs to
So if Colby can get into a position here, she's on yellow, isn't she? I quite like putting the black on the yellow.
Oh, what she's doing, she's getting coverage on one ball. And now she's gonna look at potting the yellow onto the other red, and then smothering the other red.
Ah. Yeah. What's that? So what would you do here, Jamie, on yellows?
I'd pop the ball in the bulk line.
Yep.
And come up back to the bottom end of the table, and then put the yellow onto the red. All right, I got a question apparently. Sorry, Shell, I can't read the chat feed from here, so Dan can relay all messages. So who in my opinion has, and you Steve, you can give insight on this as well, who has the best break in the country and why? I am going to say James Delahunty. He has got the most powerful break by an absolute mile, but he doesn't use it because he can't control the white. So he actually takes a bit off it.
I'm gonna say Michael Scarry.
I knew you were going to say that.
Just because I think he's got 1% more cue ball control than Della.
Well, I don't even think Della is the best breaker in the country. I just think he's got the most powerful break. But the best
question was who's got the best break.
Yeah, the best break for me, it's definitely not Ben Noonan, I know that.
No, I don't think Rusty.
Rusty dumps the white too much. I think Steve Woods' break is very good.
Yeah. Yeah, Joel Younger's is very consistent. Ron Kelly's very strong breaker of the balls as well.
No, I don't like Ron's break compared to others. Don't like Justin's break compared to others.
But yeah, scary. Mark Robertson breaks well when he's not got a sore shoulder.
Yeah, Robbo does break well actually when his shoulder's not injured. Yeah, Alec uses a 9-ball cue to break. It's a tough one, Shell. There's so many people to choose from. And this frame has just been tactified to the hell and back.
I think you'll find that the top five players in the country all break well. Yeah. I don't think you can be a top player in Australia without having a very strong break. So
yeah,
they've all got different ways of breaking, though. I mean, Jamie here actually puts his hand on the table.
Wow.
Which is very rare. But also, this year's world champion, Sean Chipperfield, breaks with his hand on the table as well.
He's a genius. He copied me. Actually, Steve Halliday does have a very, very strong, powerful, good break.
Yeah. I think the players that have the really strong, powerful break are the most consistent on different tables. I think on the tournament tables, which have typically got brand new cloth, the balls split beautifully all the time anyway. So I don't think you need to be a James Delahunty breaker if you're playing with a really good table, which is a new cloth. But on those older cloths where you've got to put a bit more elbow grease in, those guys really do does make a big difference.
You know, I reckon Mick Hill got asked this question last year when he was here, and I can't remember who he said. But when he said it, I happened to agree with it. He might have actually said that he just really liked Woodsy's game.
Yeah, that was it. Yeah.
Yeah, that was in Ballarat in the exhibition match. Yeah.
So, Colby, a great chance to go 6-2 up.
Needs to miss the black here. It's a good shot. Well. She checked it up nicely.
So should be fine here. There's a little bit of nap on these tables, so
she won't roll it.
If you're gonna roll these, then you must always go far jaw.
She never soft rolls these. She always plays them.
Okay.
There you go. So.
Ooh. Just dropped in. That's a good 6-2 lead there. So contrastingly now, who's got the worst break in the country?
The worst break in the country.
Who's got the worst break in the country?
I know you've got me eyed off there.
Not at all. No, your break was going pretty well recently.
I'm going to say Bill Vassilou.
You don't even know how Bill breaks. You're just hanging shit on it. No, I think the worst breaker I've seen in Australia, probably Jason Foster.
No, I think at the elite level of all the elite players, Benny Noonan by a mile is the worst break. He dumps a white way too much. I'm not kidding. He's the worst breaker out of all the guys that have got crazy ability. He is the worst break. Imagine if he could break better. Has Bella got the best women's break?
I think she probably does. And it's because of that cue action.
I need to think of interstate girls here, because there are some good girl breakers out there.
Who's asking the question, Dan? Oh, Dan himself is asking the question.
Bella's already up there. I think Elise has got a good break.
Elise Mabbitt?
Yep, she doesn't move a lot when she breaks, and she's got a good compact and well-timed break.
Yeah, and Elise, I think it's going to be making a comeback this year.
She's coming to the big guns, I heard.
I reckon she will definitely get back into the game. It's so hard to stay away, I think, when you've won so many titles.
I think you'll find she won't bother with nationals and worlds and stuff anymore, and she'll just play some tournaments and stuff, you know, big tournaments. Like this lady's big guns, that sort of stuff appeals to her, you know.
Yeah. But it's great to see the there's a lot of international entrants this year to the big guns. A lot of players from New Zealand coming over.
Yeah.
And also the UK and Ireland, there's people coming over.
Yep.
So that really is very exciting, and well done to Travis Crawley and Melissa Crawley, who've done a great job to build that tournament up.
Yeah, there's a lot of entries already paid up and paid for or committed to, at least with an opening payment, so.
Yeah, they've done very well there.
And of course that will be fully covered by Cueball TV once again.
There's only a few spots left, everyone, so if you haven't entered yet and you want to improve your game, the Big Guns is the tournament to go to. It's the best comp, I think, in the country. I know the Western National is a bigger comp, bigger money comp, but I think the atmosphere at the Big Guns is...
I think the room allows for the atmosphere to be larger, to bigger room.
Yeah.
I think the Western Nationals' professionalism and the way it was run is unparalleled.
Yeah.
I mean, they were using Poolstat. They had iPads on each table.
Yeah, very good. Very good stuff.
Yeah, Ron basically ticked all the boxes.
I really don't agree with wearing dickie bows attire like that.
I think that part needs to go, personally.
Yeah. Especially in WA, where it's quite warm.
Yeah, it's definitely
the last
warm
thing you want to be doing is wearing a shirt and tie. But the darts are doing well. I think the darts got it right with collared shirt.
Yeah, well, just wear a state shirt or a pool shirt or something.
Yeah.
But it is what it is.
Yeah, it's some great tournaments, and players want to come here from around the world now to play 8-ball.
And it's interesting because I'm sure we want more of these tournaments, but there's just no room. We've just got like a full year schedule these days, and
yeah,
the only real spot there is towards the end of the year, and everyone wants a break at some point.
Yeah.
Or most people, unless you're like, you know, Colby or Mick Scarry or Robbo, someone that just like wants to play in every single tournament known to man.
Yeah. So I think Rio's done a bending and toilet break there.
There's an overdue one.
And Colby on the hill.
Apparently she likes 6-2 deficits, though.
As I call it, the sovereign.
The sovereign.
Yep. So, yeah, keep your questions coming in if there is
I still haven't answered the female questions. One yet. I'm just trying to think, because Shazza Brown just won the Australian title this year. I'm just trying to think of how she breaks. I think she's got a. I think she's got a bit of a sledgehammer on her for the break.
Yeah, I think she does. Yeah. So.
God, I just can't think.
So.
I think
dry break
Sue Bocenich break's not bad.
I think Isabella has the best cue action out of all the women that I've seen.
Cue action?
Yeah.
Yeah, I
certainly
think
in Australia.
I think it's out of her and Elise. I think Elise is the other person that has a really, really solid cue action. Would love that white to have come back another half a foot to have an angle just to go into the pack here.
Yeah.
But it does have this ball on the bottom where that's looming where she can. It looks pretty plain ball to
pop
this and go into the pack.
Yeah, a bit of left hand side, but she's opting for this one first.
I don't know what's going on there. That seemed a bit loose.
Didn't like that shot.
I'm trying to work out what she was trying to achieve from it.
I think she wanted to.
Do you think the bottom one's on? The bottom of the three yellows is on.
On?
I'm just trying to work out. That's a great shot. Look at it. She's played a lot of those shots today and they've come up well.
I'll tell you what, Steve Jamieson, you are you're a genius. I didn't know you had a doppelganger. He's currently checked in with Jason Foster at the Peninsula Hot Springs for a quick rub down. I'm just waiting for Jason to see it so we get the... he'll come over, he's storming over 100 miles an hour in a minute.
Okay, so...
Oh, geez, that's moved into the rail a bit too. Colby...
I think rail's put that yellow a little bit more safe than it was.
I think Colby's going to have a dippy. We're trying to do some serious damage.
Yeah, it'd be quite a big out with a couple of balls near the cushion. But certainly makeable.
Well, all these yellows are gettable, so she's got to do something. Not bad.
Yep, so probably going to take the harder ball here, pocket weight, in her over.
Yep. I don't know the pocket weight's the go here. I think you want to commit, because if this does go in at pocket weight, you're going to have nothing.
Ah, true. She might need to just hit it a little bit hard.
You really want to just clear the black with the white, and then you'll have an angle on the red to either extract the red off the rail or land behind it and play it.
That's nicely done.
Well, she's landed behind it anyway.
That's a beautiful shot.
That's a great shot.
One of the things I really learned from Ben Noonan was... If you watch Ben play, he gets really close to these rail shots. Whereas a lot of other players like Rusty's and people like that, they leave themselves a little bit of distance. But the closer you get to them, they are actually far easier.
Oh, for sure.
But the margin of difficulty is so much better. Sorry, so much higher the further away you are. More than I actually considered until I watched Ben play.
Yeah, if you can land a foot behind any ball down the rail, you're feeling pretty good. If it becomes 2 and 3 foot, then it just
becomes
missable. Well, every opportunity here for Rio to take this frame now. Yeah. Like I said, she seems to be a big fan today of being 6-2 down. She's already done it once.
Yeah, she's done the comeback today once already, so she'll fancy the job.
Well, she'll know, if anything, that 6-2 down is not lost because she's already done it once today. So
it's going to be tricky to get on this black, though. She doesn't have an angle to get down for the yellow in bulk here. She's got to play the one in the middle of the table. First.
Oh, actually, this is okay.
Don't like that.
I don't mind her playing this and come off a side rail and back out, because you want a thin angle anyway to play the black in the middle. So you want to be pretty high on this yellow.
Yeah, but she could have just rolled it in.
Yeah, I would have rolled it in. I would have too. And then I'd just drop it in and play the same shot.
So this is unnecessary difficulty. And for some reason, she likes the cut shot here. She doesn't fancy... This is where someone who plays the cut here doesn't back their own cueing.
It could be that...
if she plays the cut, she thinks she's canning.
She's actually missed heaps of cuts like that today. Undercut them into the middle like that.
Yeah.
I reckon it's maybe the fifth or sixth one I've counted today that she's missed like that.
Okay, well, that's good feedback for Rio to take forward and sort of maybe work on the cut shots.
And the majority of the time that she's taken that shot on, it's probably not the correct option either.
And I think if she watches this again, she'll see that she really had to keep it simple there and just roll the three balls in. Yes, the last yellow would have been very difficult, but which is why she's trying to extract it effectively. But I think trying to play it down the rail as a pot would have been the way to go there. So Colby. Looking to take the match.
It's really weird. I don't know why she screwed off that, because...
And get a place in the final.
I would much rather have been more to the right inside the table so I can play this ball over the whole dead weight and just pick the gap for the ball in the middle. It's harder to pick the gap now. She's playing the plant, in fact. Okay, fair
She's
enough.
She's played it really well. Yeah, that was well done.
Yeah, that is
That's a match winner right there.
Should be. Only just needs to clear the black.
She needs to be careful here. Just when I play these, I actually imagine I'm playing going up for the blue or the pink. I don't think about getting on the red.
Yep.
I just sort of imagine going up for that blue or pink here.
A little bit of
nice
side.
Little bit of left-hand side.
Now we'll play the
Not
black in
much.
The middle, I think.
Yep. Yeah, I think she does have a bit
of
an
angle.
That's
perfect, that angle.
So, and also contrastingly on these shots, I pretend I'm playing to get on the black in the bottom
that.
Left corner, because it's such a shot that I've played so often playing snooker.
Yeah.
That I think, right, I just need to get on the black here, standard get on the black, and I'm on the black in the middle.
She's screwing off this.
No, she's just dropping it in.
It looked like she was hitting the low.
No, just a little bit of drag, just to kill the pace on the white. And this black, I reckon, is definitely going in.
Yeah, I don't see her missing this.
This is for a place in the final.
I'll tell you what, I said we probably wouldn't start the final for probably an hour late, and they've reeled that scoreline's reeled that in a bit by half an hour. I think it was set for 6 o'clock. Now Gus will be filthy because he wanted to come down, and that match is probably going to be over by the time he finishes work.
What time's Gus coming down?
I think he can't leave until about 8 o'clock or something like that.
Okay.
So he's in trouble. Bad luck, Gussie.
Well, I'm going to take a break, guys, and I'll try and join you again later on. I'm going to have a bit of a practice for a little while.
I'm going to have a break as well.
I might come in for the last few frames if there's a spot still going. Cheers.